I really need to give you guys an update because things changed and also a lot of things appeared. As you can see already a little bit behind me, I have some gorgeous, gorgeous things over here that I need to show you. I was just sitting out here for a bit, enjoying the peace and the quiet, listening to the birds. Right now it is still shady over here, but the sun is coming and it is going to be a beautiful, beautiful spring day. First things first, we decided to lower the whole pergola by about 30 centimeters. I just went a little bit overboard when it came to the height of this thing, and the dimensions were just not right. And just by lowering it a little bit, it looks a lot different. Probably it's going to be hard to see for you guys to see the difference, but to me it is very clear that this works a lot better. And also, just by adding these little pieces of wood in the corners, it all just makes a lot more sense. I am very happy with how the pergola turned out. I'm also very happy with this gorgeous, gorgeous piece of wood. Do we need to talk about this? Or can we just all agree right here on the spot that this is just amazing? This is such an awkward little corner and it needed something. And we have a few of these beautiful pieces of a tree. And my plan was to use it for some pots and some plants, but now it is here, I decided that I actually just like it like this, because this is the perfect little, well, little, it's not that little, but it is the perfect garden bench. This tree was growing in what is now our cottage garden. It was big, it was beautiful, it was healthy. It took us 2 years to decide to take this tree down. It was a very hard decision, but this tree was shading the entire cottage garden. It was really not working at all. I absolutely love this tree, and I say love instead of loved, because this tree decided not to die. We took it down in winter, and by the time spring came, branches were starting to grow all along the outside of the tree stump. And that was amazing. It was also a little bit awkward because the branches were growing outwards, and that created some new problems. So in the end, I decided to tie all of these branches together in a beautiful round shape. And in the end, it looked like a very gorgeous topiary tree. I'm so thankful for this tree that has such an amazing strong will to live, but I'm also very thankful for all of these beautiful big pieces of wood that we can use in our garden. Just take a look at how beautiful this piece of wood is. It just needs a little bit of a sand and some oil. A few days ago we went to the garden center to celebrate my birthday just a little bit more, and boy oh boy did we celebrate. Besides us buying some very beautiful plants that we will talk about a little bit later, we also bought this very beautiful big ceramic pot. I saw this and I completely fell in love with it. I absolutely love this color, and if you take a look, and maybe this is hard to see, I'm not completely sure if you can see it, but if you take a look at the water, the color of the water and the color of this pot, they are beautiful together. So right now we have this corner covered, that corner too, but then of course we have a little corner over here. This is also a little bit of an awkward corner. I have this old piece of marble over here. It has a little bit of rust on it because there are nails in it. I'm not completely sure if I can remove that, but I'm planning to use this piece of marble in combination with these very beautiful old stair spindles, and I'm planning to make a little garden table with these things to go into that little other awkward corner that we have over there. Of course, these are going to be the legs of the table, but I do need to make them a little bit shorter, and it's a little bit of a shame to cut these up, but I can still use the lower part of this to create something else, so they will not go to waste. I am planning to paint these in the same color as the ceramic pot over there, because I think it is a beautiful color and it is very nice to have it in different areas to create a little bit of a unity in this whole space. We do not have this color of paint, so it means that I have to mix my own paint color, and I love mixing paint colors myself. So this is a project that I want to do today. When you use stone or marble like this, you do not even need to attach it because it is so heavy, it will stay in place by its own. I also have these two horrible looking bird cages over here, but the shapes are very nice. And with a little bit of love and a little bit of paint, I can change these into something that looks a lot better than how it looks right now. And I think it would be very nice to hang these bird cages from the pergola in combination with all the plants that we are going to hang from the pergola. I think it is going to be very nice. Painting these bird cages is not something that I'm going to do today unless I can find myself some spray paint in a nice color. But the likelihood of me finding that right now is pretty small. So this is going to be a project for another day. There's the sun. I told you it was coming. I also have a little collection of terracotta pots over here. Rogier went a little bit crazy in the garden center with buying all of these pots. And I had to think very quickly about the plants because, of course, all of these pots also need plants. And honestly, there was not enough time for me to figure out completely all the plants that I want to use. So I bought a few. I have some things over there and a lot of things over here. I do not think that it is enough. Probably we need to go back to buy some more, but it's a start. These three terracotta pots I'm planning to hang from the pergola. So I need to make some macrame hangers for these. I also have this very beautiful little thing. This came from Rogier's sister. She did not want this anymore and she thought, you know, Eva will probably like this. And she was right. I absolutely love this. I love the shape. I love the color and the whole feel of this little thing. And I think it is a very nice little plant container. So I am going to find myself some more wood and some tools and some other things, and then we are going to build the little garden table. I always think it is a good idea to do all the building projects first. Obviously, it is not going to be very hard for me to find myself a piece of wood, but I need the right piece of wood. And I saw something very nice that I want to use. Car doors. Not something I'm going to use. There's so much stuff everywhere. Sometimes it drives me a little bit insane, I have to be honest. But sometimes it is also very handy because there is always something that I can use. And I found these. There are two identical pieces of trim, so that's plenty of wood for me to use. And they also have the perfect width that I was looking for, so that is going to save me a lot of time. This is also so nice. Maybe I should show you this. Let me see if I can move these all the windows out of the way for a bit. They are very heavy. This is a little gable that came from a very old, beautiful Dutch farmhouse, and the person that owns that farmhouse needed, I think, two more of these, and that's why this is here, because Rogier made replicas of this beautiful little gable. It turned out amazing. They are not here anymore because they were finished, but the original one is still here. I think it would be so nice to make another replica of this to use for our farmhouse, maybe create a nice little gable somewhere. It is a little dream project for the future, but let me get back to business. Oh, oh boy, let me get back to business. No distractions anymore. We need to get started on this. I think I want to see if I can do most of the building outside because the weather is so lovely. It's a shame to be cooped up inside right now. Look at this huge pile of mess over here that we have to get rid of. Not everything. We are definitely going to keep those chairs. I don't know how it's possible, but mess just appears over here in this corner by magic. Last year we got rid of 6 huge trailers. The trailer is 4 meters long. And I really thought that was it. Finally, we are going to have a nice cleared, neat driveway. But no, we are back at where we started with a whole bunch of mess. Anyway, we have more important things to think about right now. We will deal with the mess later. I don't know where it comes from. Maybe we should ask Rogier that, because he's to blame. The guy just likes collecting things. What can you do about it? So let's take a look at this to see if this is going to work. I want to make this a little bit shorter anyway, because if I make this a little bit shorter, I can leave a little bit more on the bottom. And I actually think that this is a very nice fit. It would have been nice if this was a little bit more thick, but I think it will work. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to cut all the top parts of the spindles to size, and I'm going to make them in exactly the same height as the piece of trim that I'm going to use. I just need to find myself a pencil. I just spent 30 minutes just searching for all the things that I need for this little project. Sometimes it's a challenge for me to build things in here, because this is not my wood shop. At home, I know exactly where everything is, but over here it's a little bit of a different story, and sometimes it can make me a little bit moody. But the sun shining is helping a lot, and I finally found all the things that I need, I think. Also, these spindles, on some corners they are straight and some corners are a little bit curved. And of course, normally you would think to put these curves on the outside, but in this case that's not going to work, because then I will have a little bit of a gap over here where it's round. I don't know if you can see that. So I think I have to turn them, and I'm going to put the curved corners on the inside, and in that way I will have a very nice straight corner over here. I really hope that makes sense to you. I do not really like measuring things. If I do not have to measure something, I will definitely not. So just placing a piece of wood on another piece of wood and just make a line is so much easier for me. Top pieces are all cut to size, and I want these spindles to be 30 centimeters high, maybe a little bit longer. Let's make them 32. Okay, well, here you go. Sorry, little spindle. This looks a little bit strange right now, but I think when it all comes together, it is going to look okay. It's still a little bit weird to have this beautiful part missing, but yeah, this is going to be it, you guys. This is going to be it. Because this does look a little bit strange, maybe it would be nice in the future to add little wheels underneath here. I think that would help, but for now I think just by sanding these very straight edges a little bit, it is also going to look a little bit better, I hope. But let's focus on the frame for now. 68 centimeters by 40. And I want the frame a little bit smaller, because I want a little bit of an overhang. So
let's make this 4 centimeters smaller than a marble. Then we have a 2 centimeter overhang all the way around. All about how the smaller pieces need to be. 36. Right. Now I remember. 36. Cutting all of the top pieces of the frame in a 40 degree angle. It's quite hard to get it very precise because I'm not used to this saw. This saw blade is just very thick, so it is very easy if you are slightly off to make it a few millimeters too big or too small. You have to eyeball it a little bit. But so far, it is going okay. I really felt that I was eyeballing just a lot, but I managed to get them in exactly the same size. Heavy. Well, we have ourselves a little garden table. This marble is so nice to use in the garden because it is low maintenance, it is very easy to clean. It is also going to protect the wood that is underneath it, at least for a little bit. So I think we need to give this cute new little table a little bit of a scent. And then I have to mix myself a nice paint color.